Hit it.
Alright, here you go.
Okay.
That was kind of a cool shot, but... Keep going.
Keep going! Keep going!
You can be influential from anywhere.
Do this up quick, man. There's gonna be people coming. You're gonna get in trouble.
Living in the Midwest, it's like you're a starving kid for skiing, you know? It's like you get 3 months out of the year to do it and you have 9 months to think about what you're gonna do. And then sometimes you just couldn't stop yourself, you know? It's like, I gotta go hit a handrail. And then you would just do crazy, crazy things that you would never do these days.
And unnatural is the way you don't like to do it.
We're going out in like the summertime, stepping onto handrails and shit. We literally like back a pickup truck up to the top of a handrail. I want to hit a fucking dub king, big one. I want to be ready, you know, I want to hit real shit. And like, so that's what you did, you know, you just went out and stepped onto handrails in the summer. And skiing to me is like, it all started back in the Midwest, just riding around with my friends. You know, I had no clue that there was a ski industry or a ski scene, per se. It's like just the crew, you know? It wasn't like, oh, I'm gonna try to ski like this pro or that pro. We were always on the style of like being better than each other. It was always about like burning the other dude that you were skiing with that day. It's like, what can you do to burn this dude into the ground?
Mike, give him a fucking taste.
Thank you.
pretty sick, man. Like, the older you get, like, you obviously learn more things and your life evolves and you get goals, you know? You get goals that you didn't have when you were 18, living on the floor, skiing, you know?
Yeah, things have changed since the last movie. I got married, I got a wife now, we have a kid, so we got our own little family going.
First rail ever, right there. Story on this place. We were looking for houses and all this and whatever, and everything was just so expensive for like nothing, you know, for no land, small house. So the kitchen's up here, obviously. Living room, bathroom, couple bedrooms. For $1,500, you can't go wrong.
Definitely a big accomplishment. It might not look so right now, but
pretty fired up on the whole deal. Actually own something, you know. I got my first loan on a, being a skier, you know, that's something that's pretty hard to do. Like, you go to the bank to try to get money and they're just like, wait, what do you do? And I'm always looking on Craigslist and stuff, and this trailer was 4 miles down the road for sale.
How'd you get it here?
It was nuts, dude. Like, I put the tires on and everything and the tongue and called them. I'm like, all right, it's ready to haul. I'm thinking they're gonna be like all paranoid and like, you put the tires on, you know, really, blah, blah, blah. Dude, they hooked up to it. They're going like 65 down the road with this whole house just plumbing, just loose on the bottom, like clothes hangered on. It was crazy. But daddy got off work that day to watch that event. It was sick.
What the fuck?
You know, like, I'm not a T-Hall, I'm not a Candide. Shit, some kids, dude, might not even know who I am. You know what I mean? Like, that are coming up right now. But the more skiing I do in the cities, that's, like, what keeps me excited. I'm 31, but it's, like, you can ski in the city for a long time. If I'm 50 doing it, then I'm 50 doing it. Like, that would be sick. It doesn't even matter what tricks you're doing. It's just the fact that you're out there doing it. That's the goal. That's, like, what I want urban skiing to be, you know? Like, anybody could go do it. If you're going to go watch your kid sled at this hill, like, you might as well bring your skis, dude, and go down it a couple times yourself. Like, why would you not do that, you know?
Okay. There comes a time.
Thank you.